The MA in Environmental Architecture is a 12-month program at the Royal College of Art, whose main goal is actually to try to tackle, from the perspective of architecture, the ongoing climatic breakdown. My name is Godofredo Enchpreda. I'm the head of program for the MA in Environmental Architecture.
I'm Christina Yeros, and I'm a tutor in Environmental Architecture.
So we know that, or hopefully everyone across the planet knows, that the world is undergoing dramatic changes. So we're facing global warming, we're facing the acidification of waters, desertification. We see irregular weather patterns of immense violence sometimes taking place all across the world. We see fires and droughts. All this stuff is on the news in every city, in every country, in every region of the planet. So the question for us, I suppose, is what's the role of architecture and how do we as architects approach these questions? And so the program has been constituted in such a way not only to bring the knowledge that we already have of architecture to bear on these questions, but actually to think how do we recompose what constitutes architectural knowledge, what constitutes a type of architectural practice in these situations.
So we have several different studios that are form the core of the program. Each one is situated like on the front lines of particular struggles. So specifically cited and working in collaboration with communities, with activist groups, with scholars like engaged in those issues in those places. And these, each of the studios runs for at least 4 years. So these are long-term engagements with long-term relationships that are both carried by the studio, but also carried by the students themselves, who after the first month really start to build their own relationships and ways of working with these people and with these sites.
The way in which this program distinguishes itself from similarly concerned programs from the field of architecture at large across the world would be our commitment to trying to think and work in relation to those communities that are in the front lines of environmental change. Because for us, there's a big difference between thinking about environmental and climate questions or ecological issues at large and thinking them with those whose lives are being directly, immediately, and currently affected by those situations.
And I think that collaborative practice, whether it's happening here in the studio between students or with, you know, different communities that are outside of architecture, have a different relationship to what architecture might be or do, or what its materiality might be, exactly, is what really opens up the kind of work that happens in this program. So architecture might not be a building sometimes. I mean, it's really dependent on what a site, what a group really feels is needed in their situation. Some really unexpected kinds of media come into play, some unexpected kinds of engagements with sites. And I think that's what is often surprising for students and also for the communities we work with.
I think that's really crucial to make that point, because if I would go back to the memory that I have of all the projects by students throughout these years in which the program has existed, we really see the benefit from that decision of having an interdisciplinary cohort and of having students that come not only from different geographical backgrounds, but from different academic backgrounds. Because in the end, you end up not only with the types of projects and the types of ideas that we imagine might emerge from the program as we plan it and structure it, but actually much better with a bunch of projects and ideas that were completely unimagined by us and much more interesting than anything that we as tutors could ever come to expect. And that's the result of the conditions given to students, not only through the program, but also through the fact that the program is cited in an arts university. So the Royal College of Art not only has a school of architecture, but has a school of communications, of humanities, as a multiplicity of different perspectives into contemporary issues, you know, and not just environmental architecture is the one that is interested in ecological issues and environmental issues. People in textiles, in ceramics, in fashion, in media are interested in these issues. And what this college provides are opportunities for our students to benefit from those encounters, to work in partnership with students from other programs and from other schools. Mm-hmm. And more than everything, the capacity and the possibility to be inspired by very different types of work and very different approaches to work and to research. Our main intention, and something that is actually crucial to the Royal College of Art as an institution, is to foster the capacity of students to come together after university and set up a meaningful contribution in the field. And that often depends on their capacity to lead, both in studio, both in processes of design and of research. And by leadership, we don't mean leadership in terms of one person that speaks for everyone else, but actually leadership in terms of having the confidence to design, having the confidence to ask questions, having the confidence to do things in a slightly different way. And we see that more and more and more, that our students are coming out of the MA Environmental Architecture. And while a lot of them are going into a traditional design pathway, a lot of them are also finding the opportunity of creating new types of professions, mm-hmm. of occupying positions in fields in which typically you don't have architects in, for example, within an NGO, within an activist organization, within a humanities research organization, within a popular organization, with a government body. So the range of positions that our students take speaks not so much to a student that is following a pathway that has been laid out for them in advance, but actually of students that come to the program to gain autonomy. And with that autonomy, make incredibly singular and specific decisions as to what you want to do in life and with your future, and how can you mobilize yourself and your interest and your skills to actually address the challenges posed to us by climate change, by the breakdown of weather patterns and climatic systems. And that's an incredibly important and serious challenge. We're very playful in the program, but the questions that we address are not playful, are very radical, very important, and very urgent.